In today's How to Play video, I'm going to teach you how to play a deck of playing cards. And more specifically, a deck of playing cats, the cute little decks that feature artwork from various Tatewu Designs, Sunrise Tornado Published, and Kayami Illustrated Games. Looking into the rule set, there are an unbelievably mind-boggling amount of variants for this deck of cards. So today, we're going to be doing one variant for each of the five decks of cards sent to me. And in every game we're going to be playing, the Jokers will not be used.
Spring.
TriPeaks Solitaire. TriPeaks Solitaire is a single-player game played with a single deck of cards. The goal of the game is to successfully discard all cards in the play area. To begin, shuffle the deck, then form an overlapping series of cards consisting of three peaks of four tiers. The bottom tier will overlap and meld all three peaks into a single formation as seen here. Also note that all cards in the formation start face down, with the exception of the bottom tier of cards. Place the rest of the cards in a draw deck in front of you, and flip the top card to start your discard pile. The game consists of a player doing one of two actions over and over until either the deck in front of you runs out, or you successfully discard all cards in the formation. These actions are 1. Discard a card from the formation. To do this, you take a face-up card from the formation and place it on top of your discard pile. The card you choose must be either one number higher or lower then the card on top of the discard pile. Aces in this game are both the highest and the lowest card, so a king or two may be played on them. If you can't discard a card from the formation, flip over the top card of the deck to put a new card on top of the discard pile. When drawing cards, you will begin to free cards from tiers above. When you discard so that a card or cards are not blocked by the tier below them, flip them face up. These now become playable options as you discard from the formation. You'll either win by discarding the entire tri-peak, or lose by needing to draw from the pile in front of you when it's completely empty.
Summer.
Palace. Palace is a 2-5 player game where the goal is to be the first player to play all of their cards. If you play with more than 3 players, you will need to mix 2 decks of cards together. Shuffle all the cards together and deal each player 3 cards face down. These cards remain face down in a line in front of each player. Deal each player 6 more cards that they can look at. From these 6, they choose 3 to place face up on top of the already face down line in front of them. The other 3 cards create each player's starting hand. Place the rest of the cards as a shared draw deck in the middle of the play area. The player to the left of the dealer plays their lowest card, or cards, face up next to the draw deck as their first turn, creating the discard pile in the process. After which, they draw from the draw pile back up to their 3-card hand minimum. Play proceeds clockwise. On a player's turn, they must do one of 2 things. 1. Play from their hand. In order to do this, they must play an equal or higher number than the card currently on top of the discard pile. In Palace, an ace is the highest ranking card. If there's no card on top of the discard pile, they can play any that they'd like. Multiples of the same card can be played at the same time. 2. If a player can't play a card, they must pick up all cards in the discard pile and put them into their hand. In the event that 4 or more of the same numbered cards are played on top of each other, the player that played the 4th card burns the discard pile, removing it from the game entirely. They then start play again by playing from their own hand. 2s and 10s can be played on any card. A 2 will reset the value of the discard pile, making any card in the deck playable as the next move. When 10s are played, the discard pile is burned and removed from the game. After a player plays a 10 or a 2, they may take the next turn. After the center deck is depleted and a player has played all the cards from their hand, they then play from the 3 face-up cards in front of them. If they don't have a legal play, they must choose a card to put on top of the discard pile, then pick up the entire pile into their hand. Again, their hand has to be empty to play any cards in front of them. Once the 3 face-up cards have been played, a player moves to their face-down cards, which must be played blindly. The first player to play all cards from their hand and in front of them wins.
Fall.
Blind Man's Bluff. Blind Man's Bluff is a poker variant. Instead of betting rounds, it can be played with a point system, which I'll be explaining here. Each round, a deck of cards is shuffled, and one card is dealt face-down to each player. Without looking at their own card, all players hold their card above their forehead so that they know everyone's card but their own. Starting left of the dealer, a player can choose to remain in the round or leave the round. Everyone that leaves the round loses 1 point. If they do choose to leave the round, they place their card face up on the table. Once everyone has made their decision, those still in the round compare cards. The highest ranked card wins 5 points. Those that remained in the round but lost lose 3 points. Points often go into the negatives. For ranking cards, ace is the highest. The suits are ranked in terms of value as follows, from highest to lowest. Spades, hearts, diamonds, clubs. After a set amount of rounds or points earned, a winner is declared. And if preferred, you could play with the betting rounds using poker chips instead of the point method.
Winter.
ERS. ERS is a game with many variant rules that can be played with two or more players. Shuffle the entire deck, and deal every card so that all players have as equal a number of cards as possible. The goal of the game is to obtain all the cards. The player left of the dealer starts by flipping the top card from their deck and playing it to the center. The player to their left does the same, and so on in a clockwise fashion. When a player flips a face card, Jack, Queen, King, or Ace, the next player has a limited number of chances to flip another face card from their own deck. The number of cards they're allotted are 4 chances for an ace, 3 chances for a king, 2 chances for a queen, and 1 chance for a jack. If they are unable to produce a face card in the allotted amount of chances, the player before them takes the entire discard pile and adds it to the bottom of their deck. Slaps. Players can steal the discard pile if they see specific patterns. This is where the variants come in, but I'll mention 2 popular ones, and you can always add others. If at any point, one of the predetermined patterns shows up in play, any player may slap the deck. The first to do so picks up the entire discard pile, adds it to the bottom of their deck, and begins the next round. 2 commonly used patterns for ERS are when 2 of the same ranked cards are played on top of each other making a pair, or when 2 cards of the same rank are played with a single different card played in between, a sandwich. Again, these slaps can happen at any point, even when one player is attempting to produce a face card after one has already been played. Players that lose all of their cards can even attempt to rejoin the game by slapping in. If a player with cards slaps the deck in error, and there's no pattern, they must discard the top card of their deck to the bottom of the discard deck. Play continues until one player has obtained all cards.
The original cat deck.
Speed. Speed is a 2-player real-time card game where the object is to be the first player to discard your entire deck and hand of cards. Shuffle the deck of cards. Deal 2 face-down piles of 5 cards, 2 card lengths apart from each other in the center of the play area. Then deal 2 face-down cards next to each other between the piles you've just created. Give your opponent 20 cards and keep the remaining 20 for yourself. Each player deals themselves a hand of 5 cards from their personal deck, setting the remaining cards next to them. At the same time, players flip the 2 cards in the middle, and play begins. There are no turns, and play goes as fast as possible. From their hand, players can play cards to either of the 2 face-up piles in the center of the table. In order to do so, they must play a card that is 1 higher, equal to, or 1 lower than the card on the top of the pile. Players can always have 5 cards in their hand, but never more. If at any point both players are unable to play cards, they each flip the top card from the spare piles to the left and right of the play. If the spare decks ever run out and both players are stuck, flip both piles in the center, face down, move them to the side, and flip the top 2 cards into the center again, creating 2 new spare decks to use. The first player to play all of the cards from their deck and hand wins. And that's just 5 of the thousands upon thousands of variants you too can play with Deck of Cards. Be sure to check out all the decks seen here at Sunrise Tornado's Kickstarter, linked in the description below.